Good morning, everyone. In 2018, researchers from MIT came up with the lottery ticket hypothesis. In this video, I'm going to describe what it is and why it's important. Pruning in neural networks is a technique that has been used for quite some time. The idea is that while all parameters within a neural network work together to calculate its output, many parameters can be removed without heavily damaging the network's accuracy. Thus, pruning a trained network, one can achieve a model which is up to 90% smaller with negligible effect on the network's ability to perform, saving precious memory. The techniques used to prune networks are outside of the scope of this video, but it's important to be aware that they exist and are effective. The main idea of the lottery ticket hypothesis is that a neural network, which has been initialized with random parameters, can be pruned to a significantly smaller network before training while still achieving comparable results. For example, a network might have 6,000 parameters and achieve 98.71% accuracy once trained. Within that network, there is also a subnetwork of much smaller size, say 600 parameters, which achieves 98.7% accuracy once trained. The key here is that the pruning is being done before training rather than after training. If this hypothesis is correct, it could potentially save many hours of training time and increase the efficiency of the network. The hypothesis may also lead to the design of better networks as we learn more about what makes a winning ticket a winning ticket. The authors set out to prove that such subnetworks actually do, in fact, exist. Thus, they came up with the following algorithm, which prunes the network initialization. The first step is to initialize the neural network, keeping track of these parameters, denoted by P0. The next step is to train the network for a little while. This training isn't like full training, where the model must become as accurate as possible. Rather, we're trying to determine which of the initialized parameters lends themselves to the task. We only need to train for a fraction of the time in order to do this. The third step is to prune this slightly trained model, which can be done using the same techniques that prune a fully trained model. Again, these techniques are outside of the scope of this video. Since we trained the model for a short time, this should successfully prune out the parameters which were not helpful to the task. And since we didn't train for a long time, this pruning should also give us an indication of not only the current parameters, but also of their initializations. If a parameter is currently ineffective, its initialization is probably also not part of the winning ticket subnetwork. Finally, we can reset the parameters that weren't pruned out back to their initialization, P0. We repeat the process of training, pruning, and resetting over and over until eventually we've reached our winning ticket initialization. Once the winning ticket has been found, the network can then be trained fully. Typically, the algorithm runs until a certain percentage of the parameters are pruned out. However, the algorithm can repeat indefinitely. Pruning out too many parameters will degrade performance, as the smaller networks will lack the capacity to fully learn their task. Often, pruning until only 2 to 10% of the parameters remain is the best. After reading the paper, I was inspired to attempt to replicate the results. Despite my code being rough, I was still able to achieve comparable results. I implemented the algorithm on an MNIST classification model, which is a model that classifies handwritten digits. The accuracy of the winning ticket was 95.5%, while the accuracy of that same configuration when reinitialized with random values was only 90.34%. I also implemented the algorithm on a CIFAR-10 classification model, which is a model that classifies small images into 10 different classes. The full, unpruned model achieved 76.24% accuracy, while the winning ticket achieved 79.3%. The fact that the winning ticket outperformed the unpruned model was surprising. The authors of the paper showed a similar phenomenon, speculating that the full model might have too much capacity, whereas the winning ticket models generalize better. Thank you for watching to the end, and I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to click the like button and check out some of my other AI tutorials. You might enjoy them.